35th segment in the DC TV series on the network of global corporate control. Today's segment will continue to follow up on a prayer of Ferdinand Marcos. If America fails, then the world is lost. At the end of World War II, Ferdinand Marcos, who was the lawyer for José Rizal, the superior general of the Jesuits at the time, put the world's international monetary gold reserves and other wealth into a trust called the Global Debt Facility for the benefit of humanity for 50 years. The story of how the CIA overthrew Ferdinand Marcos's presidency in the Philippines went viral on the internet last week. I'll summarize the story, which a friend in the Philippines uploaded on the internet and forwarded to me. A prominent journalist in the Philippines, Eric A. San Juan, originally published this story in 1998. San Juan was friends with James Brandon Foley, a CIA agent in the U.S. Embassy, in 1986 when the EDSA revolution overthrew Ferdinand Marcos. EDSA is named for Epifanio de los Santos Avenue, the street of the CIA and Vatican-engineered demonstrations against Ferdinand Marcos. The story also includes how Ted Koppel and Newsweek tried to destabilize Ferdinand Marcos, how the mainstream media ran stories blackmailing the Marcoses, and they gave promises to the workers and renegade generals that they would be able to immigrate to the United States. Cardinal Jaime Sin played a very prominent role. Sin told Cory Aquino, who ended up replacing Marcos, that she should hide in a Cebu convent during the coup. The CIA used traitor Voltaire Gazmin to secure Cory in Cebu. After the coup, Marcos left the Philippines and went to Hawaii. He did this peacefully to prevent deaths during this seizure of power, and he did this at the insistence of Cardinal Sin, who was backed up by the Vatican and by the United States State Department. Cory ended up heading the Philippines after the coup, and here is the deal that was offered to Ferdinand Marcos by the Trilateral Commission, which Marcos turned down. He was told that he should sign over all the assets in the Global Debt Facility, except for 1/4 of 1% commission. And by the way, that amount of the commission, that is the amount of the commission that we are going to be offering those people who will be signing these assets, because as I've been mentioning, these assets are still in the Global Debt Facility. They're available, and they're the assets that we are going to be using in the global currency reset. Another part of the deal that was offered to Ferdinand Marcos for signing away the world's wealth was that the Philippines should lose their own currency, and the Philippines currency would become dollar denominated, and people in the Philippines, instead of being given actual money, would have to use a debit card system. By the way, that's what's now in place in Norway. They're experimenting with the Norwegians on that approach. And the other thing that they were asking Ferdinand Marcos to sign away was to sign away all the natural resources, to give the bankers perpetual rights to natural resources in the Philippines. In my tweet where I forwarded this story, I included a list of the assets in the Global Debt